Hey you, my name is Thomas Tomscar Ridgewell, and welcome back to Content, the show on the internet that happened, whether you like it or not. One of the first games I ever played in this series was called The Presentation Game, wherein I would be given a subject at random and made to give a presentation using images that would load behind me at random. I had no idea what was coming. That was the game. It was improv. And people liked it, and they said, you should do another one of these. And I said no, because the first one was good, it'll all be downhill from there. But guess what? I'm over the hill now, so why not? Let's do it anyway. Here's The Presentation Game 2. Now, it may be hard to believe, but this used to be me. I mean, look at me there. Cone on my head, stop sign in hand. What other public amenities was I going to steal? This is how bad it truly got. I had a DeviantArt account. My life was off the rails, as I'm sure many of yours is. I mean, before coming in here today, I asked you to tweet at me your greatest mistakes, and this is what one of you sent. Truly upsetting. Can't even fit in the door. I'm here to tell you that there is hope. If you follow the advice I'm about to give you, this could be you. To be clear, you're the baby. Why would you want to be the baby? Because you don't want to be this! No one wants to be that! He forgot everything but leg day! Step one, perhaps the most obvious, stay hydrated. It's important to drinky winky. Step two, advance in your career. Now, this may seem like the ends of the product of being motivated, but really, it's just the start of your journey. You see an opportunity to advance in your career, you take it. You get on that couch, or you get on those knees. That didn't feel good. And number three, but remember, if you stay hydrated and you suck that dick, you will be on fire. Metaphorically, and maybe literally. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. This has been in no way a help to any of you. Get fucked.
Yes, it is me, Mr. Superhero, your arch nemesis, Graybo. I am going to destroy... I have brought you here because I'm going to destroy the world, and I'm going to tell you how I'm going to do it in an extremely elaborate monologue, giving you ample time to thwart all my plans. Did I say that out loud? Anyway, you see your world, Superhero Man. I'm going to shoot it with peanuts, and all the people who are allergic will die. But that is them taken care of. What about the others, you say? Well, he is terrifying, is he not? I have unleashed him onto the world, and he will slice, and he will dice, and then he will do a shit on the... that's one of his, yes, he's very naughty. It will march all the humans into my elaborate death camps. Death camps, you say? Yes! Here they are. My death camps are on the moon! No one will be able to stop them! What's that, Superhero? You think you can stop me? How are you going to stop me? You think you can throw the cheese and stop me? Fool that you are! No, I have thought of that. I have the ultimate cheese-stopping machine. Boom, he's coming. He's a little late, he's on the trip, but he is coming, and he will consume all of the cheese. And when he's done, oh, when he's done. No! How did he get here? He was supposed to be dead! This cannot be! How have you amassed such a powerful army of allies? Oh no, the others, they're arriving! It's Mr. Pisser! He's here! No, and also, Garfell, please, have mercy on me, Superhero, for I am but a humble supervillain. Oh, I'm so depressed. It's a terrible idea. I'm so sorry. God, it's quite warm in here, if I'm honest with you.
Hello, yes, come in. I'm so glad that you're interested in this property. You know, truthfully, it's been on the market for a little while. I don't want to indulge rumors, but people like to say it's haunted. So anyway, come on through. Let me show you the living room. See, here we have the living room. Ignore the dead body. But look how spacious it is. It's wonderful, isn't it? Now, let's go through to the kitchen. Here we have the kitchen. It's so oh my God. I really thought they would have taken that out by now. This is perfectly normal fixture in this town. You're from out of town, right? Yes, yes. No, this is perfectly normal. If you don't like it, we can have it removed. Dining room, right? Everyone loves the dining room. This is the dining room. You're screaming? Why are you screaming? Okay, so full disclosure, a hentai addict did die in this house. Their spirit may still be lingering around, but you know, again, we can have that removed. We can clear it out. We'll call in a shaman. We'll call in an exorcist. No problem. Let's look upstairs. All right. So here we have the guest bedroom.
Ah!
Okay, okay, so, all right, look, okay, now, look, it's fine. Look, let me just give that to me. Okay, so, yes, there is a death cult here, and they do like to sacrifice, bitch, don't talk. They do like to sacrifice babies, but it's fine. Every house has its quirks, you know, you can learn to live around. You want it back? Okay, here you go. Into the fire? Lovely, fantastic. Now, one more room left. Let's just jump into it. The main bathroom. Now, I will be honest, may have the scariest ghost in the entire house, but again, you can probably have it dealt with. Or not, maybe you like it, maybe you want it to stay. Here he is. Nope. That's just the sink. Ignore the sink. The ghost that I was trying to talk about. Like I said, you're new to the area, but to be honest, if you're buying a house in Area 51, you should expect some silliness, you know? Here are our resident ghost grannies cutting up a ghost alien. They will do this 23 hours a day. They will fade into obscurity at roughly 3:15 a.m. And so it gives you about an hour to shower, to toilet without them being in there. It's not a big deal. You know what? Fine. Don't have a house then. Don't have a house. See if I care. You don't even want to see the garden? Well, look out the window. This is the garden. You could have had this. The garden is also a bedroom. You're leaving? Fine, I'm gonna go into the garden bedroom and fuck this Elmo. Hello, yes, it is I, leader of your country. Things have been grim, yes, but allow me to briefly distract you with this. Oh, isn't he lovely? People are dying. People are going hungry. People are suspicious. What are they suspicious of? COVID. Where is it? Who is it? Why is it? You'll be happy to know that we have an answer. We have found the origins of COVID. It came from the boys. Have you been out with the boys lately? You've got COVID. So now that we know where COVID comes from, we know how to stop it. Get out into the wild. Go lick a tree. Because as we all know, COVID can't climb trees. Star Wars. Beloved franchise. Space opera. Odyssey buzzword. A thing we all loved growing up. But what happened to it? Social justice warriors pictured here. Who can get this franchise back on track? Who? That's right. Me. A straight, white, fat, bearded man. I'm what the world needs right now. And I would like to introduce you to my new Star Wars movie. I call it... That's fucking done me in. Wrong slide. Here's my movie. Star Wars and the Halls of Endor. The classics, Ewoks, Chewbaccas, they're all here. Have we introduced any new characters? Absolutely not. We're bringing back fan favorites, such as Beck. And who could forget? Yoda. There he is. That's right, we're pandering. See that? That's us. What are we worshipping to? A toilet. Who's the toilet? It's you, the Star Wars fans. We're giving you everything you wanted. Because in this movie, we're straight up shoehorning other franchises that we know you love. Thomas the Tank Engine, the Addams Family, and who could forget, Winnie the Pooh. Now that's all I really have time to tell you about this upcoming Star Wars project, but there's one more little secret we have left. Need I say more? Oh, I do? Robert Pattinson's in the movie. Surprise, motherfuckers! The SJWs are back and we're putting Twilight in your Star Wars! Fuck you! Woo! Wow. Heaven. What a night. God! Is that you? May I come in? No! Fuck! Why? The things I've done? You don't have any proof of that? You have proof of it. Look, it was a phase, okay? I thought it looked good! I like the frosted tips. You can't deny me entry to heaven for that. It's not like I did anything else. You have more pic- You have- Oh, fuck. In my defense, thought it was a very sexy lady. I said, hey, bitch. She turned around. How was I supposed to know that it was actually a dog? Okay? It was one time. What? It's not like we got up to any other weird shit.
Oh, fuck. We did.
Hello, class. It is me, your teacher. Now I know that this year is a little crazy. Steve? Steve, stop fucking around. I can see what you're doing there. I don't like it. Get off the ceiling, Steve.
Stop fucking around. We got an important class today. My voice has already changed. That's right. I'm a mafia teacher. Forget about it. Okay, class. We got to get back onto our little cheeky curriculum. So here's what we're learning about today. Bada boom, bada bing. It's a... We're going to learn how to swim. Why the fuck not? This man here, he never learned how to swim. Look at him. What's that, Jimmy? You don't know why you need to learn how to swim? Well... You don't learn how to swim, this is what's gonna happen to you, Jimmy, huh? That's waiting for you in the water. Your head goes under? He's there. He's waiting for you. He's not gonna fuck around. You want that, Jimmy? You want that, Jimmy. Alright, boys. I think we're pretty close to a breakthrough in this case. But let's go through the crime scene photographs one more time. When we first entered the scene, this is what we saw. Recall it? That was a dark fucking day. Get it? A dark fucking day? Like... Doesn't matter, moving on. Sorry, that was in poor taste. Then we got down the hallway. The perpetrator was still there. My God. Scariest fucking moment of my life when he threw that hamster at me and he got away. I'll never know who it was, though. He was so damn fast. And then finally we got to the crime scene and what did we see? Boom. Now, I'm sorry I didn't warn you boys before I put this picture up on screen. I know it's scary, I know it's unsettling, but Jesus Christ. That kind of shit shouldn't be allowed to happen, not in a civilized society. I guess someone taxidermied a cat and put a gun on its tail. Real fucked up thing. As you know, we've been out there, we've been canvassing, we've been speaking to neighbors. We spoke to this ugly motherfucker. He was no help, but God, I just wanted to look at his face one more time. Christ alive, that shouldn't happen. However, we then spoke... to this character. A child. A little slow in the head, but rife with information. They drew us a picture that got us one step closer to the identity of our murderer. Bada boom. I didn't want to believe it either. I think it may have been a Smurf. How does Smurf do this? I don't know, they got tiny little hands. To get us over the final hurdle of this crime investigation, I'm gonna bring in a little extra helping hand. That's right, boys, you've heard the legends, but here they are. TD's McGee. He can suck the truth out of any criminal. Here he is interrogating the Brooklyn Strangler. And just to help boost your morale, here's a picture of my wife. Ain't she a looker? She is not. Well, I hope you enjoyed that absolute disaster of a video. If you didn't, feel free to leave a comment in your head. Just leave it there. You don't have to type it out. I don't want it. Here's my favorite fan art this week, and here are the most recent contents. Contents come out some Tuesdays, including next Tuesday, which will also be the last Tuesday, because the series is ending. Maybe the world's ending too. I can't promise anything. Don't get your hopes up. What am I saying? Tom Scott out.